Supermarket chain Woolworths will release its full-year profit results today. The retailer expected to report a 5% increase in sales to about $67 billion. That's why the Greens are after it. Joining us live now, the business reporter for us, Edward Boyd. Ed, good morning. This comes after Coles reported a lift in profit yesterday.
Coles' profit yesterday was $1.1 billion, a little bit better than expected. The shares went up to their highest level in 2 years. And look, Woolworths has had a pretty similar year to Coles. Aussies are still buying lots of things in supermarkets. In fact, Coles said yesterday, people are cooking more food at home because it's quite expensive going out, which means they're spending more money in supermarket stores. So we saw supermarket sales increase at Coles. Alcohol sales didn't rise as sharply, but they lifted their dividend yesterday. Expect Woolworths to have a slightly better result than Coles because their sales are about 25% more. They've got a bigger market share than Coles. So we should get the Woolies results in about an hour, maybe an hour and a half's time, Pete, potentially a little bit earlier, but it'll be released to the ASX very soon. We'll get the stock market reaction just after 10 a.m.
Okay, yeah, we'll bring that to you as it drops. Meanwhile, the Woolies boss, Brad Banducci, he'll step down after today's results, Ed.
Yeah, well, 6 months ago at the half-year results, he announced his shock retirement or resignation. It was called a retirement, at least in the media. But remember, we got the footage on the screen now. He basically walked out of an interview with ABC where they were doing an investigation of price gouging, faced some tough questions. He did came back and then finished that interview off, but he is stepping down. The most recent press release says it's happening in September. So obviously this is the final part of the financial calendar for them for this year. Once he's presented these results today, I imagine he'll hand over to Amanda Bardwell, who's a Woolworths executive. She's going to take over as chief executive, it says in September. So expect her to start probably on the 1st of September next week.
Got it. Now, another big economic moment for today, Ed. The July inflation numbers will be released later on this morning. So what's the read here in your view? We could fall to 3.4%. That'd be quite a drop.
It would be quite a drop. Remember, the June quarter numbers came out recently at 3.8%. But this is the monthly inflation numbers. So it's a bit more volatile. They only look, the statistics only look at about 60% of all the prices across Australia's market, whereas the quarterly number looks at 100% of the prices in a basket. But look, we know inflation is slowly coming down. In fact, Coles yesterday said inflation in the financial year 2023 was 6.7%. In the previous year, just the one that's just passed, it was around 2%. So it has come down quite significantly. And we're going to see it probably fall even more today. So expect to see 3.4%. There might be a bit of a stock market reaction, but we've heard from the RBA, they've said rates are going to be on hold all year. So I don't think the numbers today are going to shift the dial too much in regards to the cash.
Yeah, interesting. If it drops to 3.4%, to see how the Treasurer and the Shadow Treasurer spin that in their favour. Ed, thank you.